Hi friends, welcome to Sada Learning Hub. You are with me, Sadashiv Rao. Today's session, we are going to learn add sorting order to a criteria object, criteria reference. Now, in this video, I'm going to discuss about how to add sorting order to criteria interface, reference object. Now, before moving into that, why criteria comes into the picture, what is the criteria and all those things. First, why criteria? Yeah, in a Hibernate, we have supported to do curl operations on a single object or in a multiple objects. If you want to do the single object, there is a save, update, and load. There is a different methods are available to do on the operations on the single object. If you want to do multiple objects at a time, if you want to do operation on the multiple objects at a time, we are going to use HQL or criteria API or native SQL. That's why criteria API comes into the picture. See, if you want to do a operation on a multiple objects at a time, criteria API is going to use to do multiple operations on the multiple objects at a time. We are going to perform the operation on the multiple objects at a time. Now, if you see, it is the another technique to perform the multi-row operations in the Hibernate. The criteria API is the another technique to perform the multi-row operations in the Hibernate. Using the criteria API, the only possible to perform the, see, by using the criteria API, we are going to only possible to perform the select operation. It is not possible to do the non-select operation. It is not possible to do the non-select operation. In the criteria API, the queries are generated by using Hibernate. To construct the query, we need to pass the class object of a pojo class. See here, we are not writing any queries, just we are creating a classes and interface references to create a criteria query. That Hibernate itself is going to take care to create the query. Now, to store the query constructed by the Hibernate, we need to reference of org.hibernate.criteria. We need it to store the reference of an query. Now, we can obtain the reference of the criteria interface by calling create criteria. How we are getting the criteria reference? By calling create criteria method, it will give you the criteria reference object. This create criteria is going to take a class object of a pojo class. Now see how we are going to create a criteria reference. See this, there is a create criteria method available. This is the create criteria method. It takes an argument of pojo class. It takes an argument of the pojo class. Now it will return the criteria. It will return the criteria reference. Now, if you execute this criteria, it will returns the list of all records from the database. It will give you the all the records from the database. Now, I will show you how to add sorting order for the criteria reference. While loading an object from the database, we can add either ascending or descending order for the objects to load from the database. For example, if you are loading the 1000 records, definitely we are going to make the ordering for that particular objects by, it may be an ascending order, it may be a descending order. To add the sorting order, we call add order method of a create criteria. See, after creating the criteria, we are going to add order to our criteria. We are going to give ascending or descending. It will take it based on that one. We need to order class object for adding the sorting order. Order class is from org.hibernate.criterion package. See, if you want to add the order to your criteria, definitely we need to pass an order object. We can pass the order object. Based on that order object only, it is going to create, order your rows. Now, we need to order class object for adding the sorting order. Order class object to sorting the order. Order class is from org.hibernate.criteria package. It is available in this particular package. Now, if you see a simple snippet of the code, this is the simple snippet of the code. Now, this is the create criteria. It will give you the criterion reference. It will give you the criterion reference. This is the, I am passing the class object of a pojo class. Now, this is the criterion reference. This is the criterion reference. Now, after that, simply I am creating an object of order. See, this is my creating an object of order. In the order, there is a one static method is available. The method is called ASC. ASC is an ASC is the method. It is available in order class. Now I am calling that particular method. It will give you a reference of order class. Now this is the employee salary. Now I am sorting my employees based on the employee salary. Now I am calling the crit.addOrder. Now simply I am calling the add order to my criteria. That is, I am passing the order object. Now simply I am calling the list method. It will give you an ascending order. It will give you a ascending order list of objects from the database. Right? Now if you want to add the sorting order, we need to follow this one. First, we need to create an object of criteria object. After that, we need to create an object of order. That particular order object, we need to add it into your criteria. Finally, we are calling the list method. It will give you a criterion reference. Next, for this, I am going to show you a simple example. Now, this is my simple example. See, this is I am creating a simple Maven project. Add sorting order for an object using criteria. Now, here there is a two files are there, resource files. The first one is hibernate.cfg.xml. It holds the connection properties and hibernate properties and as well as the mapping resources. And coming here, these are the two Java classes I am going to use. The first one is employee.java. It is a pojo class. And create API client, I am going to use this one to perform my order. These are the two things. Now I will show you an example how to do in the real time. See, I'm to close this one. See guys, if you want this project, the link is available in the video description. Just get the link and do the practice. All these projects are available in my Sada Learning Hub GitHub repository. If you are searching Google also, it will give you my GitHub link. Anyways, I am providing link into my video description. Just go through that video link. Just go through the link. See here, this is my pom.xml. I am adding my dependencies. The first dependency is my Hibernate dependency and the second dependency is my Oracle dependency. These are the two dependencies I am going to add it in my project. And coming here, these are the two resource files. The first one is hibernate.cfg.xml. In the hibernate.cfg.xml, I'm going to make it connection properties and Hibernate properties and as well as the mapping location of the my resources. These are the three properties are available in my hibernate.cfg.xml. And coming to the employee.hbm.xml, here I'm going to map my file. I'm going to mapping with my pojo class with my database. This is my class name. This is my class name and this is my table name. If you see, ID is my primary key column and properties are non-primary key columns. We need to map with our pojo class property with a database column name like this. Now coming to Java classes, I am created a one pojo class at here. This is my pojo class. It contains a properties. There are the four properties are available: employee, employee name and employee salary and a department number. These are the four properties and remaining all are setters and getters methods. Next, coming here, I am creating a simple client to check my application, all the configurations. The first one is, now this is my configuration object. I am reading my hibernate.cfz.xml. And coming to, I'm creating a session factory object. This is my session factory object. I'm creating a session factory object by calling the build session factory. The build session factory, it takes a service registry. Next, I'm opening the session. After opening the session, now here I'm doing my actual work. See, I'm creating a criteria reference by calling create criteria method. The create criteria method, it takes a employee class object of a employee class. Next, I'm going to create an order object by calling order dot method AAC or DESC. There is a two methods are available. If you want ascending order, you are going to call the AAC method. If you want to descending order, you are going to call the DESC method. See, these are the two are available. Order is the object, and order, I'm calling the order dot AAC or DESC, which one we want. Next, coming to, I'm adding my order to my criteria API. See, criteria reference, there is a one method is available to add your order to criteria. That is called add order. Now I'm adding my order to criteria. Simply, I'm calling the list. Now it list returns the employee objects, which is in ascending order. Now my employees objects are all in ascending order. Finally, I'm iterating, I'm printing it here. This is about to add an object ascending or descending orders. I will learn and show you, is it really ascending or is it really working or not. Okay. See here, my objects are, I got it in ascending order, but my output is printing wrongly. That is not at all an issue. Slow depends on slow and down. See, ascending order 2, 4, 1, 3, 5, 6. I'm ascending based on my employee salary. See, based on my employee salary, I am done the ascending order. If you see the output of this one, if you see here, I am coming here. See, the first one is 0, 2 is the 0, and second one is 0. It is going in ascending order. The first one is 100, and the 3 is 300, 5 is 500, and 6 is 500. Now it is ordered successfully. Now this is a way to order your, add order object to your criteria API, criteria reference. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please, please subscribe our channel, Sada Learning Hub. If you like this video, please click on the like button. Thank you for watching.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel Sada Learning Hub, because we have many session that would help you to develop our skills, and I will be back soon. Till then, you take care. Bye bye.